You're live.
And coming to you live from Cleveland, Ohio, you're watching the Ghost of the Podcast on Rivalcast Media. Yeah! It's so weird. I don't hear the music because we are in Studio 2 right now. Yes, we're in Studio 2 right now. You guys, I don't think you guys can see this yet. But here we are right now. We're getting ready. We're setting up the Ouija board and everything here.
I'm so excited. I got to be a producer today and I didn't fuck anything up. Huzzah!
Are you going to transition the camera on? Or?
Oh, I should probably do that.
That would probably be helpful. Otherwise, all your painstaking work you've done this afternoon goes for no.
So look at this beautiful overlay. And
look at that.
There's a secret surprise for our Ouija thing for later on. So
for our Ouija
awesome
thing for later
is.
On. I like it. It's very good. It's definitely different to be this much on camera. Usually we're not.
We might have to adjust because when we were setting up the overhead cam, we actually have an overhead cam today. I'm so excited. When we were setting up the overhead cam, we were positioning it specifically for the Ouija board itself. I forgot about the obelisk and stuff. So we might have to pan that out just a little bit. However,
all right, so we might have to do that a little
super
bit.
Super excited. That'll take like half a second.
So ladies and gentlemen, so what excited. Do we have set up for you tonight? Well, as Baroness said, we are having a dual camera setup here coming here in a little bit once we decide that we're going to go ahead and work on the Ouija board. We had to, because of the dual camera setup that we're running, we had to set up in Baroness's studio for today's episode rather than the usual studio that you guys are used to seeing for our Ghost in the Podcast
stuff.
They
see it on tap. I mean, they've seen this studio
that
numerous
is true.
Times.
That
on
is true.
Tap.
They've seen this part of the studio, but they haven't seen this part.
Yeah, they have.
So all sorts of cool stuff that we're doing tonight. So as promised, we've got the Ouija board set up. We've also brought down the obelisk. We brought down the K2 EMF meter. I will explain what those devices were, how they work here in a little bit. She brought out the magic 8-ball because reasons.
We have brought out all this magical stuff.
I'm assuming this is the runes.
Those are the runes, yes.
Those are the runes.
Those are the runes.
Everything short of tarot cards, I think we're good to go.
I don't have tarot cards.
We will have to get tarot cards for sometime in the future. And then figure out how to do tarot somewhat believably. We were having a conversation about that yesterday at the bookstore. So that is the big thing we're going to do today. And we're going to see if our ghost hunting equipment will actually respond to the Ouija board. And the reason we decided this, in fact, it's actually been a very interesting week since we decided to do this. At first, we were deciding, you know what? I've always wanted to play with a Ouija board live on the air. I've wanted to do this for a while. You were always against this for the longest time.
I was.
And to explain why to the viewers, why you were so against this idea of bringing a Ouija board into the home.
So the thing you have to understand about, you know, otherworldly phenomena is basically whether you're talking about magic or astrology or ghost hunting or whatever, what you're doing is you're dealing with the manipulation of energy. And while I don't believe in the Ouija board, I mean, let's take a look at this Ouija board here. I'm sorry, I couldn't help myself. Look at that. Look at that beautiful Ouija shot. Your keyboard's in my Ouija shot.
Sorry.
But I mean, look at it. I mean, it's like...
It's not bad. Not bad at all. A little off-centered, but there we go.
Ridiculous.
We're good there.
I mean, you've got this, and you're supposed to, like, you know, everyone touch it and just open your mind, and then it magically, like, gives you messages from the great beyond. I don't buy that bullshit. I'm sorry, I don't. But the thing is, the entire point between any of this, if you break it down to its little core element, is that you're manipulating energy. And whether it's psychic energy or what have you, it's just, I don't think that we're going to be bringing demons in, but at the same time, it's like, are you opening parts of your psyche to things that aren't necessarily real? You know what I mean? I don't think we're going to start playing with this and it's going to be like die, bear, I don't know what letters are, baron. I don't think that's going to happen. If it does, that would be kind of funny. I'm not going to lie.
I think it's funny that you don't know where the letters are.
I don't know.
It's in alphabetical order, honey.
Yeah, I know that. Well, there's splits and, you know, when I was learning my alphabet, okay, so the name that my parents gave me, because my last name now is not my last name when I was born.
Right.
But my initials went JLK. And in the alphabet, it goes JKL. So when I was in kindergarten and we were singing the alphabet song, when it would get to that part, I would always get called up by my teacher for singing JLKMNOP. She would correct me and I would say, no, 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 I know how it goes. And so, yeah.
I thought you were going to keep going more.
I heard myself coming through your speakers and I got very concerned for a minute. Like, wait a minute. We were just talking about how this was bullshit.
I'm not.
And now I'm hearing
device.
Voices, but it sounds like me and I'm pretty sure that's in my own head.
All right. Now, since we've announced that we were going to be doing the Ouija board, some interesting things have started up here at the home. Now, you guys have heard us before. Those of you that listened to this show before, we've talked about the possibility that maybe there's something here. We've never had conclusive evidence one way or another, but we've had some really spooky shit go on that we cannot explain over the 3 years we've been here. Almost four now.
Again, manipulation of energy. That's all it is.
It could. It could be.
And my energy is going to, like, wipe out whatever.
Some things I've seen. I don't know if it's quite as simple as just manipulating energy, but it is possible. I mean, we had the ghost and the pisser. We had my experiences when I was ill and seeing the woman in white walking around. So I don't necessarily buy... It's just energy stuff. It could be. Could be, because how the fuck are we going to know unless we start testing? Which, by the way, that's what we're going to do tonight.
That still holds. Like, seeing apparitions still holds as energy. Because, I mean, think about all of the ghost hunting equipment that we have. I mean, we've got the EMF meter.
It's not that they're not composed of energy. It's that the energy manipulation is coming from an outside source. Like, coming from one of us. That I don't necessarily buy.
I didn't say that about that part. Okay. I said that about Ouija.
Gotcha.
That's what I was talking about.
Gotcha.
Ouija is definitely, I mean, okay, if we're just sitting here, like, focusing and this, and not touching the table, no touching, fins of arrested development, no touching, and this thing starts moving around on its own and spelling out messages, okay, then I might be a little impressed. But the entire point of this game, I looked up the rules to this game when, okay, so.
There are rules?
It's marketed. This one's a Hasbro thing.
Yeah, it's kind of the other part of it is it's kind of hard to take a Ouija board seriously when it's coming from Hasbro or Parker Brothers or
Parker Brothers. Milton Bradley owns Hasbro now, so or the other way around. I don't remember, but okay.
I remember even telling you yesterday. It feels weird buying a Ouija board at a bookstore as opposed to like some really weird off the wall thrift shop.
Did you know that Ouija boards are rated for children 5 and up?
So children 5 and up can play with demons.
Kindergartners.
We can send people to their deaths before they drink alcohol, and we can also let them summon demons before they're allowed to consume alcohol. This makes a lot of sense, folks.
So, okay, this one is saying 8 and up, but there are other, like, Ouija versions that, okay, it's the threshold that I've seen is 5 and up. So, okay, adult assembly required because... Although this is a very simple piece of ridiculousness, you had to stick that middle part in yourself and put the feet in yourself. That's the adult assembly required.
Gotcha. I don't know why they just didn't put it all together, but
that's what I said. This is retarded. I spent $27 on this stupid
piece of cardboard.
People
feel more involved if they have a task.
Okay, but it has instructions. So this is 2 to 4 players.
Okay.
Because apparently anything more than that, you're just going to start, you know,
players
fucking with each other.
I believe the preferred nomenclature is summoners or mediums.
No.
Bullshitters.
That would all be if, you know, you weren't playing a game. So this is a game, so it's play.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is a game. Okay, I thought we were doing some serious research here.
This is a game. So I assembled the planchette. I did that by myself in spite of the instructions clearly saying never use the Ouija board if it's just you. Don't do that. I put the planchet together myself, and, you know, damn it, call Zach Bagans, I might be possessed now.
Yeah, nothing's happening.
I don't know. I feel the need to put my hair up in, like a fin.
That's why I'm wearing the hat, because the fin's already set up. And it has a little ball on the end.
You are trying to mess with destiny is what you're doing.
I like to think I'm a master of my own destiny. Here, pass me that little blue pillow there. I need a...
Oh,
need a lumbar support here.
I thought I gave you that.
No, I need a little bit of lumbar
support.
Maybe
the demon moved it, or maybe I just moved it when I was moving.
I think you moved it when you moved all sorts of shit. But anyway,
it.
So
you are supposed to be keeping an open mind, Baron.
I have a very open mind. I'm one of the most open-minded people I know.
Anyway, all right. So here's the instructions. So after I broke the rules already and saying never use the Ouija board alone and assemble the planchette by myself. I might be possessed now. We're not sure. We'll see how the rest of the episode goes. But, so step 2 is begin your quest. Gently place the planchette in the center of the Ouija board. So we've already fucked this up. Put it over the T, I guess. Gather closely around the board if you dare. That's actually written right there, if you dare. Each player place two fingers lightly on the planchette, and then you begin to ask your questions. Now, the way it goes in this game is the bravest person has to ask the first question. No, you're afraid of spiders, so obviously I am.
We're not dealing with spiders. We're dealing with demons.
Maybe we're dealing with ghost spiders, Baron. You didn't think about that.
There's no such thing. As open-minded as I am, even I have my limits.
You don't believe in ghost spiders.
Okay. I suppose if ghost raccoons are a possibility, it's an inside joke for an unrelated story. I really doubt there's ghost insects and arachnids running around there. Pretty certain it's not the case. Because that would assume that spiders have souls, and they don't. So there you go. That solves that one right there.
I accept that line of logic.
They want you to turn the this camera on.
Oh, turn the Ouija camera on.
Yes.
We're not really doing anything with it yet.
They want it. It's there. Right. You gave them a shiny toy, and now they want to play with it.
I did give them a shiny toy. They're so excited. I'm so excited. We have never had two cameras before. We should have done this at New Year's.
All right, is there any other...
What are we thinking?
Is there any other
rule? Oh, yes. Okay, so the bravest person asks the first question. We always have to speak slowly and clearly, just as friendly spirits prefer. We also have to be patient. If the planchette doesn't move, just ask another question and focus. Because it's obviously not because this is hokum. It's because you're not focusing enough.
Gotcha.
And finally, when we're finished asking questions, we have to move the planchette to goodbye, because that is good and proper manners when dealing with the spirit realm.
Okay, that works.
So be polite, and if you don't get answers, it's not because it's stupid, it's because you just have to be patient. This might be a long episode.
All right. So, with that being said, and taking a little bit more of a serious bent here, to know it's kind of hard to take a subject like this seriously, and we understand that as people are coming in and dropping out right away.
That was not the Wailing Wind Band. That was the box.
We've had some interesting experiences here in the house. You guys have heard us. For those of you that listen to this episode, to the show before, you've heard us talk about some of our experiences. And I know we were joking about the ghost and the pisser. Just to give you a short overview for those of you that haven't listened to this before.
Yes,
when we first moved in to this house, Baroness and I had to do a whole bunch of renovations because there was a lot of damage done by the previous owners. And one of the things that we had an experience of is we have a bathroom on the first floor. It's right inside the front door, right down a long hallway. And the door was off the hinges because we were renovating that bathroom because of all the damage and stuff that had been done in there. And when we were walking by and we each had this experience, we saw a man standing inside that doorway and the lights were off. Nobody was there. The previous owner had recently passed away, but not in the house.
Yeah.
They had moved out and then he passed away within like a week or two in a hospice care. So we thought maybe, hey, it's, you know, this dude, because it took about a month to get everything up and going before we could actually move in. But since that time, things kind of calmed down a little bit. And then I got sick, last month, very sick. And during that process, I thought I had seen a woman in white that kept appearing around me when I was home. I know you said when you're home alone, a lot of times you hear footsteps and things walking around upstairs, maybe even up on the second floor. So we've had a lot of weird experiences that we can't explain. And what was interesting about the most recent one, and of course, I can't say 100% certain this is a ghost, but it is something that definitely stands out, is this actually happened when I was streaming a game. Some of you guys may recall this, for those of you that were watching, I think it was a Wolfpack episode last week.
Yeah, it was Monday.
So I'm sitting in my chair and I'm playing games. I've got the camera going. Everybody can see, you know, playing Final Fantasy Tactics, a modded version of it. You're down in the basement, and it doesn't really matter where the cats are because what happened, they couldn't possibly reach. But in the top of the basement stairway, right next to my office where I'm playing, and then you're down in the basement, there's a little, I don't know how you describe it, like a little light fixture, a little glass fixture.
There's an overhead light right at the landing where the intersection is for the garage when you come in.
And while I'm playing, and keep in mind I'm playing video games, it's not like I'm stomping around the house smashing shit or anything else, all of a sudden this thing falls out of the ceiling and shatters everywhere. Makes a huge ruckus, scares the crap out of me on stream. Which would have been hilarious if I was playing a horror game, but that day I was not. I usually save that for the Friday stream. And it was just really weird, and nothing was out of place. Nothing had been moved. The bolts that were holding this thing in were still in place. In fact, it didn't even look like the pieces that were intact where the bolts went. It didn't even look like they had been affected
at all. The bolts are still in there right now.
So,
and they're still fully screwed in.
it was just a very, very weird situation. And the other thing that's been happening to me lately, and this is something I haven't actually told you about yet, because remember how I always said, like, I have recurring dreams? Like, I have, like, this I always have a dream of a particular location all the time. Mm-hmm. I've told you about this before. Yes. Ever since that happens, every single night, I am having that dream. I'm in this location, and I'm freaked out about something, and I wake up, and it's like nothing happened. It's been happening every single night since this happened, and it's weird. Could be unrelated. Very well could be. You look very skeptical.
No, I wonder why you wait until you've had... You just wait too long to tell me these things.
Well, it's not like it's anything you can do about it. I mean, it's a dream's a dream. You got to deal with it. But I just thought that the time frame of this actually happening is kind of interesting. Now, before, when I would have this dream, I've had this dream for many, many, many years. And basically, to tell you guys a little bit about it, from what parts I remember, is I'm always out in the woods and I come across what looks like a mansion pretty much in the middle of nowhere. Now, there's, you know, open fields around it, and there's just this building that's there. It's a building I've never seen before, I've never been in before, and every time I go inside it, I'm always there for one of two reasons, and the inside of the building is always different. But the same feeling and the same missions is why I'm there never changes. I'm either there for ghost hunting purposes, because there's something that happened I'm trying to document, or I'm trying to find something. Something is hidden somewhere, and I never know what it is I'm looking for. But I know I'm supposed to find it. And as I'm going through the various rooms of this mansion, creepy shit starts happening. I start seeing, like, I don't usually dream of people I know. Every so often, somebody I know will actually be in there, which is rare for me. I almost never dream of somebody I know.
Oh, you did tell me that I was in one of your dreams lately, because it was really strange.
And it was. Like, there wasn't anything bad that happened. You weren't doing anything particular. It's just the context of which you were there and why I was there, it just felt like you were out of place in that dream. Like, you weren't supposed to be there. And it was not good that you were there for whatever reason. I don't know why. But I just remember having that feeling very vividly. Okay. And then I woke up. And then, of course, as you wake up, details kind of disappear. That's why I can't give more details than what I got.
That's fine.
So it's just, like I said, it's just been a weird little occurrence, little things that have been kind of happening ever since that light fixture fell out, which is just funny because it was literally not even 24 hours before that we decided, let's break out, let's go get a Ouija board and let's do this. And then, boom, shit starts happening, which I think is amazing. I think it's cool as hell. Not that I think they're necessarily correlated. I mean, there could very well be a logical explanation for the light fixture falling. Who knows? I just don't have one. It doesn't make any sense as to why it happened.
I don't think it fell. I think it exploded.
What, after it hit? Well, when it
No.
Because I heard it hit, and then boom.
I get that, but I think it started before it fell. I think the only way that those bolts could be completely in, which if you go up there right now, they're still completely in.
Right.
I mean.
The light bulb still works. No problem with the light bulb.
Yeah.
We did not have to replace it. Nothing went wrong with it.
So.
And it's not like it's a new light fixture. That thing's been on there for years.
But that, the glass, and I told you that when we were picking it up, the glass was hot. So I'm pretty sure it exploded.
Could be. Which, like I said, that could be the logical reason. But it's just kind of funny just how little shit starts happening. So what we're going to do tonight, like I said, we're going to do the Ouija board. I broke out some of the ghost hunting tools that we've had, because I am an avid paranormal investigator. I do believe in paranormal stuff.
Jesus is a very long fucking cord.
That's the replacement cord. I can't find the original.
Oh.
So we're going to show you guys a couple of these tools real quick. The first one that we're going to show you is the obelisk box. Go ahead and do it for the overhead so you can actually see it. We're not doing this yet, so we can move this. We're not doing this yet.
While you talk about these things, I don't move the...
Just so they can see this, we'll move it back.
I was going to pan it out so that we could get the whole thing together. All
right, we'll go ahead and do that. Go ahead and do that.
You are messing with my production values, Baron.
Production values. Anyway.
Christ
so this is the obelisk box. She'll zoom in and she'll show you what this looks like a little bit closer. Zoom out, I mean. This is the obelisk tent, version 10. I almost looked up at the ceiling one. And basically what the obelisk does is it takes electromagnetic field energy, because the theory behind spirits is that they're composed of energy, and if so, they should be able to give off magnetic fields. Those can be measured. So that way if you find like some rampant random magnetic field, supposedly you are possibly having a paranormal experience. Although, again, this is all just in theory. There's nothing conclusive one way or another. So what this box supposedly does, and Baroness and I talked about our own skepticism about whether or not this actually works, because we've tested this out many times before, is it allows the spirit to use their energies through the magnetic fields and manipulate it to turn their energy into specific words and actually communicate with you live. There's various different settings on this. The most accurate is the phonetic version, which is just uses different sound bites so it can form basically whatever word it wants. You can even string together sentences if it so desires. The part that we're going to use tonight is because this is a dialogue box that goes with it that'll show the words that pop up. We're going to use dictionary mode, which comes with about 2,000 words already programmed into it. Now, a lot of people watch these Ghost Hunter shows and they're completely flabbergasted by how awesome the Elvis box is. Bear in mind, they give you access to the software this comes with, so you can change the words as you see fit to your dictionary. And the value that goes to them is pretty much arbitrary. It could be anything. So we're going to try both versions. We're going to try the dictionary version first, because that way we can use the dialogue box to see exactly what it's saying and just look for patterns of things that, that comes up. And then we're going to put it in phonetic mode and just kind of see what happens randomly and see if we can actually get something that's not already programmed into the machine. And there, again, there's several other modes. Those are the two that are only worthwhile. Reverse phonetic mode's not bad, but that's a little bit harder to understand. The other tool that we have, which works very similar as the EMF meter, or as the Ovilus, is the K2 EMF meter.
Which should probably not be right next to me.
It works very similar to the Ovilus, except instead of trying to form things into words, it uses the lights here to tell you how strong the signal is. Green being the weakest, red being the strongest. For those of you that saw our most recent Orbfest episode, there was a room where the majority of the time we were in the orange and red area, which we were able to find out why that was. We were able to actually debunk it. Turns out we found out that wireless signals from a hotspot we were using to broadcast can actually affect with an EMF meter. So we don't have that. We're running off corded signal tonight, so we don't have that issue. This would already be highlighting if it were. Now, any electronic device can give off an EMF meter, but as you see, is this is pretty stable here in the table where the laptop is, the microphone, the computer, the cameras. Nothing is close enough to set this thing off at the set this thing off while it's sitting here. And one of the ways you know that it is something coming from an electronic device is the signal is very strong and it's consistent and it lasts a long time. So both of these things work off similar frequencies. So the goal is if this one's going off, this one should be going off in theory. So they should be going off together. So as we're doing the Ouija board here and trying to go ahead and use our energies, and yes, I think we're going to have to take this somewhat serious to make this actually worthwhile. We're going to try to see what we can measure and just see if there's anything that happens, anything that's interesting out of the ordinary. Don't know what it's going to mean. If it does, we're just going to test it and see what happens. So let's move these off to the side of the board. So if you guys have questions about the different ghost hunting tools we're going to use, please feel free to ask as we go along here. Again, I'm really passionate about doing it, so I don't mind talking about it. I actually get excited when somebody wants to know more about it. But again, nothing conclusive. It's always just, you know, always just theory based. A couple of the devices that we were going to bring down that we decided not to, just because there was no real feasible way to do it, is we're going to bring down a EVP recorder, which stands for electronic voice phenomenon. Basically, disembodied voices that you don't hear as we're recording, but show up on recording later. Well, we're recording this. You're hearing audio now. So there's a good chance that if an EVP happens, you guys are going to hear it before we do. And then we can go back and rewatch this and see what happens. Of course, this introduces the possibility for trolls to fuck with us, but that's why we can always watch the episode back later and find out how truthful they were. But yes, in all seriousness, no, if an EVP does happen, you guys will stand a better chance to hear it than we will at this point in time. Trying to think, is there anything else ghost hunting related that we should explain before we go on here? But I think we're pretty good. I think we covered most of the bases. And real quick, for those of you listening to the audio version, you can't see the topics page here that's on the bottom of the screen. So just to let you know, some of the other topics we're going to talk about tonight, so that way if this is not really your thing, maybe you can skip ahead and enjoy some of the topics we're going to talk about. Stephen King's It dropped a brand new trailer for the remake movie that's coming out. We're going to talk about in depth about that one. Very, very, very excited to talk about this one for many reasons. And then we're also going to talk a little bit about we have a ghost gossip article tonight. About a true life supposed haunting and a location that you can buy that is supposedly haunted. We're going to talk about that as well.
Oh, I was super excited about that, although the house is kind of ugly.
Yeah, but we'll come back. We'll get to that. The other bit of news is there's this sci-fi slash horror game that's going to be made into a movie. It just got greenlit. It's a popular game. However, what doesn't make sense about the whole thing, well, you'll just have to wait and see. But basically, it's a possible rage alert for me. And for those of you that have never heard one of my rages before, I'm told they're quite hilarious. So fair warning, that might happen later.
Didn't they make a Ouija the movie?
They made two. Supposedly the sequel was good. The first one was abysmal. The critics loved the sequel.
Oh my God.
They all said it was a great movie, the sequel. So I have not seen yet. And that'll be we'll have to watch that at some point. I've got a list of movies I'm slowly gathering that I need to catch up on now that I like rarely ever watch TV or movies. Like, I logged into Hulu today for the first time to see if, like, the 1990s version of It was on there. Of course it's not. And not realizing that I hadn't logged in, like, a month, at least. It's like,
I logged interesting. In, though. Okay.
Interesting. So yeah, I know. Your recent playlist showed up. My playlist is, like, way in, in the back of the bus.
They had things that I felt like adding to my playlist for once, which made me all super excited.
Ask the Ouija spirits if they will inform you if spiders have souls. We already know the answer to that, Manly. Why would I waste our time like that?
That's kind of rude.
It's true. It's rude to waste their time on stupid ass questions.
That's what I was saying.
But in all seriousness, as we do this Ouija board thing, if you guys do want us to ask certain questions to the Ouija board, let us know.
Yep, we do have the... Actually, you know what? I can pull.
That's probably not a good thing to throw out there to ask people the same questions. Because that's probably not... That's going to come back to haunt me, no pun intended.
About being in studio, too. Let me close out our music piece because we don't need that anymore. Is we've got the RCM bot relay up, and we can actually see in bigness.
In bigness? Yeah. Really? You mean full screen? Why don't you just full screen it?
Because if I hit full screen on that, it's going to fuck with everything because the dimensions on monitor 2 are not the same as the dimensions on monitor 1.
Gotcha.
And so I lose the edges.
All right, pain so... in the ass. So for those of you that are just tuning in, you're late to the party. Shame on you. Oh, the last topic we're going to do. Last week we started our Hunt a Killer game. We're going to go through the evidence again one more time for the box that we currently have. We do have up on our Discord channel a thread that is now open to anybody who wants to discuss the Hunt a Killer game. Theories, ideas, things to look at. It does involve a lot of research. So we will be touching a little bit on that and give you guys a brief overview one more time tonight before we go ahead and finish. So if we don't get to that, remind me. I want to make sure we cover that. And we can't go much past 7, Baroness, because tonight's the only time I actually care about pro wrestling. So
tonight's WrestleMania.
Yes, this is the only time I ever actually care about pro wrestling. Otherwise, I ignore it. I don't even know who's all fighting tonight, but I just want to watch it. All right, so let's get started with the Ouija board stuff, because this is exciting. I can't wait. So...
All right, so I did light some yellow candles in the background.
Don't want to go too much further. I don't want to get burned.
Exactly.
All right, so which one of us is going to ask the first question?
It's supposed to be, you know, bringing up good fortune and good luck, and they're also supposed to be great for meditation and, you know, bringing in the positive energies. So there is a method to my madness. I've been spending an inordinate amount of time learning about candle colors and chakras and healing stones and all sorts of things.
Does madness count as good energy?
I accidentally made a... We were talking about this on Untappd the other night. I accidentally wrote a grimoire in the course of my... in the course of my working through stuff for these cults for Rogue Agent and the next story, which will be called Danger Zone. Killer's the one who brought up the idea, and every time we bring up that it has a title, he starts singing. So, anyway, I guess I'm learning some things, I guess. All right.
All righty, so here goes. Move the keyboards away. Right, all right, hold on. Turn on the obelisk. All right, it's on dictionary mode. We do have the dialogue box. I'll try to show it to you guys if it speaks. So I don't think you're going to see it on that camera. By the way, hi, everybody on the other camera. Eat. All right, so the box. Eat supper.
Well, you know what?
Country.
Put it down so that the camera can actually see it.
Rabbits. These are pretty weak signals, so it's getting a signal from something. So eat supper, country rabbits. It wants us to eat country rabbit for supper.
Rabbit's gamey, so I'm not really a big rabbit fan.
I have not eaten rabbit, so I can't really comment.
Unless rabbit is in reference to Bio being in chat. I mean, there's that.
Ask the spirits if WrestleMania is going to suck or not. Oh, we should ask him who's going to win the main event.
They aren't...
I know.
I'm not sure that they can see the future.
All right, two fingers. Not the middle fingers.
Lightly.
They're lightly on.
Light. You're pushing on the board.
I am not pushing the board. How do we know it's not the spirit that's taking this?
Well, it feels like you're pushing it towards me a little bit.
Is that better?
You need to focus your question, though.
All right. I need a question to ask the Ouija board.
Thought you were asking about WrestleMania.
No, I'm not gonna ask about WrestleMania.
Gotta clear my mind. All I can think about is wrestling now.
Yes, your mind sounds really clear. Stop shaking the little Ouija thing. All right, question number one. Let's get semi-serious here. Question number one: is there anybody else here? Oh shit! It's actually
okay. So,
why'd you take your hands off? It was moving.
Because we started laughing and then it started shaking things. Okay,
it was moving. Is there anybody else here with us? Let us know by the Ouija board or in the obelisk box, please. It wants to move. Are you pushing this?
No.
Are you? I swear to God, if you're pushing this, I'm going to flip it.
No, I think...
I'm barely touching it. I'm barely touching it.
Because it definitely
Where's
feels...
Where's it going? Where's it going? Is it 5? 6? It's going to goodbye.
Seriously? Really? Are you fucking kidding me?
I think it just told us goodbye.
We just spent $27 fucking dollars on a Ouija board and the first question is just like, fuck you, I don't want to talk to you.
Get back on this
thing.
What
the hell?
Why are you telling us goodbye? If it says because reasons, that's going to be hilarious.
What are you doing?
I'm not doing anything. D? I'm like barely touching this thing. Come on. Why did you tell us goodbye? It's moving. Where the fuck is it going now? It was you, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't. Like, seriously, this entire time it felt like you were shoving it.
Nope, I was not shoving it. Hold on, I'm watching the replay. Oh, it's friggin' buffering! Really? It froze! Oh, wait. No, there we go. It's moving.
You got a serious delay on yours.
Yeah, I do have a serious delay. What the fuck?
Are you watching it? I mean, Jesus.
Look, my hand slid. All right, let's try that again. All right, this time, arms off the table as much as we can.
Okay. All right.
All right, so we got D.
Hang on.
All right. Your turn. Ask a question.
I don't know what to ask it. You ask questions.
Oh, for the love of God. Are you male? Are you a guy? Again, I'm barely touching. S. H. I'm the one that's going to say she. All right, female, she. Tell us your name, please. Please tell us your name. Fingers barely touching. Sorry, folks. I know it's a period of silence here, but just in case something happens. Okay, sorry. We got movement. Are you pushing this?
No. Every time you ask that, I break concentration. What's it on? Because I can't see that letter.
It is on H. Yeah, I know. It's kind of hard to do this from being far here, away here.
Let's move the... Well, get close.
Well, move the cameras kind of... No, it should be all right. Here, we'll slide this stuff down. All right, so far the only question we've answered is that it is a she. All right, let's try this again.
I can move the camera down a bit.
So far, nothing on the obelisk other than when we booted it up, which happens when we boot it up, so take that with a grain of salt. It's Spanish, the S is for C. All right, so we have an H when we asked it what its name or what her name is. We're going to recenter again.
That's the furnace.
Oh, I was going to say, what the fuck was that? It sounded like a growl. It's like yeah, oh, shit.
You got to remember the furnace is on the other side of that wall.
That's right. Which is like 60-some degrees out. Why the furnace is kicking on? But anyway. Our power bills will be an issue later.
All right. I realize we haven't, because I've actually shedded my cloak because it's kind of warm down here, which is surprising. But remember, ghosts make things cold, so obviously our house is going to respond to that.
That is true. All right. By the way, folks, because we're doing an overhead thing, look, I am wearing pants.
The camera's right there.
That camera can see I'm wearing pants, see?
All right. And be careful, because the table light is right there.
I'm well aware. I've bumped it like 6 times already.
If I hadn't moved it to that position, guess how many times you would have been bumping?
All right.
A lot.
Ready? All right.
All right. Clear your mind.
Okay. Please tell us your name. H. G.
What the hell does that mean?
Are those your initials? HG. Are you still here? I just saw the obelisk light up for a second, but it didn't go off. That might just mean it's on. All right. Are you still here?
That's a silly question, though. If they're not here, then they're not going to be able to answer.
You don't see it moving, do you?
That's true.
Can you tell me my name? S. E. Is that an E? That's an E. Still moving. O or C.
Doesn't stop it.
B. A. Is that O? Or is that I can't see what it is.
That's a P.
Where's it going?
Oh, the light meter keeps flickering. Not
this did?
High, yeah, but it did.
Are you making the K2 EMF meter go off? It's this one right here. My hand was blocking, so I didn't see it.
Just saying, it said what when you asked what its name, what your name was, and it went S, and then it was still moving. It went SAP.
Call me a sap? Seriously?
That's horrible.
Or are you calling me a sap for going along with this?
No, it spelled it out on the board. You can watch the video. All right.
It went to SAP, but it also went to B and O.
No, it was still moving. You said sap. Did it? You said did it stop on O? And I said no, that's a P.
It looked like an. It looked like I could only see like half of it.
I think we're scaring the ghost. I mean, to be fair, though.
It should know what it walked into here.
To be fair. Right, can you tell us right, your name? Is there something you want to say? Goodbye. What?
Also called us a... Now called me a sap. All right.
I'm not sure I
get your hands back on this piece. We're not done yet. Hold on. I have to channel my inner positive energy. Go sniff some candles over here, because apparently that's what you're supposed to do, right? Alright.
Sniffing anything, although there are certain sects that, you know, they go into the psychedelic shit.
Bear in mind, I don't think I have the active ability yet. Not enough JP earned. Senior Baron. I think he's calling me Senior Baron. Definitely called me a sap, little fuck nugget. Alright, so you said you saw the K2 go off?
It flickered up to the second green for a second.
I'm hoping it caught it on the camera, because I didn't see it, 'cause my hand... Because the way it is my hand's blocking the light, so I can't really see it. Yeah.
All right.
All right, let's recenter.
Let's clear our minds here. And I know it's kind of hard now because you're angry.
All right. Chat, give us a question to ask. Legitimate question, not something about spider boner orbs. They've been trying hard to get that question asked. Do ghosts get boners? If so, are they orbs?
We should, you know what? We should try, okay, so the way that this board works, for those of you that can see it on our totally awesome aerial cam, which I'm still super jazzed about. All right, so you've got the alphabet, the English alphabet, you know.
Glad we cleared that one.
There are other alphabets, okay? The norm.
But we're an English-speaking show! Why would we use a different alphabet? We're not Chinese. We don't have three fucking alphabets for one language.
You'd be surprised the weird shit that comes up at RCM. Anyway, so we've got our English alphabet. We've got, you know, the numbers, you know, digits 1 through 0. We've got goodbye. We've got yes. And we've got no. So I'm thinking that maybe our best bet is not to go too complicated with these spirits, who obviously are pranksters and pains in the ass. And perhaps we should ask yes or no questions to kind of like, that's like icebreakers, you know? Like, rather than your first question being like, you know, what's the capital of Uganda?
That wasn't my first question. My question was, is someone here? The answer was yes. My second question, are you a male? It said she. So don't give me this I'm being overcomplicated BS. Although I do like Hax's question. When were you born? And please use the fucking numbers.
All right.
Ace Me has a good question. Do they know if they're dead?
All right.
That's a good question to ask.
So we'll ask that, and then we'll try and find out if you know, when they were born or whatever.
All right.
Use some numbers.
Clear mind.
It's kind of hard.
I know it is hard to do.
It's like, what the hell?
This Holy show, shit. Clear Mind, what are you talking about? This is a Barron production.
You know what? You know why we're having such a hard time? Is because we decided not to drink prior to this because we wanted...
No, we're having a hard time because we're not taking this seriously.
I'm just saying.
I'm not drinking and boarding, okay? I'm not drinking and Ouija-ing. That is, if there is ever a premise for a horror film, there it is. All right, that's like giving me Lumberjane's box and a bottle of booze and saying, go at it, kid, have fun. No thanks. All right, I don't all want right. the Ouija all equivalent all right, to all right, Pinhead all right. popping out here to make my life a little more interesting than I like.
That would be kind of funny, actually.
No, it wouldn't! There is nothing funny about Pinhead! Have you ever seen him? Have you ever seen a Clive Barker movie, let alone read one of his books? There's nothing funny about it. It's three shades of fuckery, and you are on the receiving end, okay? It is not fun. There is nothing fun about it, other than the fact that it's a good movie. You know why it's a good movie? Because we're not the one experiencing it, all right? You're not the character that opened the goddamn bottle of booze and the goddamn Limerchin box and summoned the fucking Cenobites to come in and make your life a little more interesting than you normally would desire. You are watching it happen to someone else. That is what makes it entertaining, okay? Being on the receiving end of a fist in the ass is not the kind of pornography people want, okay? Well, most people. That is not the experience you want. The theater experience is not to be an active participant. No, thank you. Okay? No, thank you. I cannot stress that enough. No, thank you. God.
Oh, my God.
Jesus. Folks, this is your warning. Don't drink in Ouija. Just saying. Hey, dead person, are you dead? That's a good question there, Manly Stuff.
Oh, God.
Oh my God. Don't drink in Ouija.
All right. We had a plan here.
Okay. So anyway.
Ace
had a very good question.
Do they know if they're dead and what year were they born? Okay. Gotcha.
All right, now let's try to take this a little more seriously this time. All right, we're gonna give this a good faith effort this time, guys. I know. What year were you born in?
I didn't feel it stop though.
Fifty-eight.
No.
Five, no. Because it stopped on the five for a second.
Oh, it's moving again.
Did the light just flicker?
I didn't notice it. What's it stopped on?
Six.
Yes.
Six yes. Five no, six yes. It's also poking at the ovalis.
Well, it's, I mean, the plant is kind of big.
True. So.
Oh, you know what?
Still going. Ooh, it's really moving this time.
And you're not pulling?
I swear to God, I'm not pulling.
I'm, like, barely touching it. In fact, my finger keeps sliding off.
I am, too.
No.
This finger keeps coming off because of the stars. Yes, no. Five, no. Six, yes, no.
No! You said, but it's kind of pointing at the ovalis, too.
Oh, I just got goosebumps on that one. Fuck, now where are we going? Oh! K2's going off.
Three.
Way above, no. Alright, so the K2 EMF meter just flickered three times while we were going down the board. Five, no. Six, yes. Ovalis, no. Three, and then a random spot on the board.
In the general no direction, though.
Are you watching us right now? And this time, don't just move the stick. Say it on the obelisk box. Are you watching us right now? And see what it stopped on.
It's like just above
J,
the...
J? I? It's right above the I. Are you watching us right now? Please answer. Five. No.
Five, no. Why does it keep going down to the freaking numbers and then going back to no or yes? I don't get that. Alright, hold on a second, because my arm is just... I'm trying to, like,
I know,
lightly
it's
hover, and
I know,
it just...
Hard,
you're
it's hard
not
to rest your hands.
It's not used to doing that. Okay, I'm gonna try, like, I know you said not to flip off the cameras, but my
go for it.
My driving fingers keep getting in the way.
Flick it off all you like, I don't care. See? What does number five mean? only stuff says it keeps pointing to the voice box.
You going to know again? Oh, it's like spinning here. It just freaking loves that word no.
Tino.
I don't.
Hey, chat, someone in chat do me a favor and write down every so often what the Ouija says as we call it out. It's getting hard to remember them all.
Yeah.
I'm wondering, just to take a pause here, I'm wondering, you know, how when they do messages, like when they're transcribing messages, they'll give, like, you know, word stop, so you know, like, it ends.
Oh, for telegraph.
Right, like telegraphs. What if we're having something like that? The numbers or the word or the letters that we're getting, if we put them all together, will give us an answer. And then maybe the no's or the yeses or whatever. I don't know. Maybe those are pauses. I don't know. But Manly Stuff is a pretty good point. It does keep pointing up to the Ovilus box. Remember, folks, that the more people touching the board means the more energy the spirit can use to talk through the board.
It occurred to me that when it's moving, most of the time it's moving really, really slowly.
Yeah.
Kind of like a dead battery, almost. Until we get excited about it, and then it starts moving faster. So I don't know.
Okay, so let's do this, because I don't know if this is something that legitimately happens, but you hear them. I hear ghost hunters talk about this stuff all the time in mediums. Use some of our energy to speak through the box, either through these or through the Ouija board.
All right,
let's reset. Reset to the T.
All right.
What do we want to ask? Well, Ace B's getting some good questions here. He's got, are you friendly?
Hax is saying get Hobbs to help out.
I don't think Hobbs is going along with it.
Hobbs is a little pissed off right now because he missed his chance to go for a walk around the neighborhood. So
I am surprised they're not down here, though. It is unlike them to not be down here when you and I are down here.
That is extremely odd.
Yeah, when you and I are down here, the cats are always down here. Always. They do not like being on floors alone. But they're not here. Interesting, isn't it?
Okay. That is an odd coincidence.
Let's go with... five keeps coming up as a number.
Did you scare my freaking cat? It's moving. It is fucking moving. Where is it moving? Are you fucking kidding me?
It's moving off the board again towards the obelisk. Well, that's a big old fat yes.
You. All right.
Wait. Why did you scare our cat? Wants to move. Goodbye.
You fucking troll! No, you get right
wait, back here and answer my goddamn question.
What?
What if it scared him to get him to go away? Maybe he's telling Hobbs go away.
You did yell at him earlier to go away.
I did yell at him earlier to go away because he wouldn't shut the fuck up. So it is possible he could be, or she, because, you know, we said it was she, was telling Hobbs to go away. Goodbye, Katie, go away. Because he wouldn't shut the fuck up.
Yeah, you were a little angry, and I did.
I was really angry. It's hard to practice my my stuff when he's screaming and yelling.
I did say that I kind of wish that Hobbs would be quiet just so that you would stop yelling. I don't like that. I don't like that at all.
Okay. We want to recenter, or do we want to keep it here? Let's recenter. Just take your hands off.
I don't like how they made this board, because if you go down, it... Yeah, and it gets caught, and then you can't move it. It's like, Jesus.
Yeah, they didn't make this kind of big. All right. All right, chat. Do us a favor. Come up with four questions we can ask. And guys, please take this seriously. Come up with four questions we can ask. AceMe's been doing an excellent job. Cats are sensitive spirits. That's true.
Hax makes a good point, too, and this is what I was getting at earlier. Make sure that we're asking questions that have one-word answers, because that's going to be a lot easier.
What happened to never playing with the Ouija board? Vampy came in late. We decided that, or we talked about that.
You look so proud of me right now, and I know why.
I am proud of you. You're letting me play with dead things. I'm very proud of you.
We don't necessarily know that the thing is dead, but...
Well, they did ask. That's a question
we
can ask.
We do know that it's admitting very quickly to scaring the cat.
Vampy wants to ask if Baron killed Wolfie. The answer to that's no, Vampy. You don't need some harlot from the other world telling you so. I'm just kidding. You're not really a harlot. Or you might be.
We could channel the ghost of Wolfie to vindicate you.
Yes, we could channel Wolfie. Wolfie will come and vindicate me.
I think we need like a spirit guide, like someone who's actually, I don't know, trained in these matters to help us find the correct spirit of Wolfie. There could be a lot of fake Wolfies out there in the spirit realm just trying to troll
you. That's true. Except Wolfie's not real, so that's part of it too. I'll tell you though, at one point I was actually getting goosebumps with the answers we were getting. That was kind of cool. That felt interesting. And we did get the K2 EMF meter did go off 3 times when that happened. At the same time I got goosebumps. Now, it has not done shit since then, and the obelisk has not done anything since we first hooked it up. So, magnetic field-wise, things have gone quiet. So far, if we are getting anything off the Ouija board, we only have trace amounts of an EMF field to measure. So right now, we have not been able to successfully measure anything. Well, no, we have. We've had glimpses of possibly measuring something, we just don't know what. We're not getting enough consistency between the two.
Yeah. It doesn't seem to have enough power behind it to set the box off. Or maybe, I don't know if, like, thinking back to, like, the battery analogy, though. Like, if it's moving this, it's not, will it have enough energy to set all the things off?
Well, that's why I said it can do it either or.
Yeah.
Either or.
I mean, it's what we are seeing are not very strong.
Right. Most of the readings we're getting are 30 or lower, and this thing can go all the way up into the thousands.
Yeah.
And obviously, the bigger the number, the stronger the electric current that you're getting, or the magnetic field that you're measuring.
We've had some strong ones before.
Upstairs we've had, but we've never tried this down here.
That's true.
Now, in all the times that we've been here, any weird experiences you've had in the basement itself, or has it always been up on one of the other floors? For me, I have never had anything weird happen to me down here. The woman watching me do the dishes, the woman in white that I've seen, the dude standing in the bathroom, those have all been up on the first floor.
I had something potentially weird, but I'm not entirely certain it wasn't just a dream.
Okay.
But, you know, when I get my headaches, I tend to try to go places where it's cool and dark, which in the summertime, upstairs is cool because we have air conditioning, but it's not dark. And here... I love my subterranean office because it's warm in the winter and cool in the summer, and it's, you know, just the right amount of light, and I had my hammock was up there, and I was napping in the hammock one afternoon and woke up I was dreaming about something, and it was something that made me wake up just enough that I opened my eyes and it looked like there was a little boy standing there.
Ooh, that's creepy.
And I remember telling it to go away because I was sleeping, and then I rolled back over. And so I don't know if I didn't get like a clear, like it was a little boy in very green shorts, kind of like if you think of like, I don't want to say lederhosen, but like those short pants that the German kids wear that have the suspenders,
yeah.
Like that. It was just very odd and just standing there. I mean, he didn't do anything. I didn't really pay that close. I didn't really get features. I just got little blonde haired. But the what stood out was the green shorts because it had like the suspender things with it.
Yeah, I don't know.
And I remember telling him to go away because I was trying to take a nap. And when I woke up later, like everything was fine. So I've never seen it before or since. But I can't say that it was actually something because I was in fact sleeping. I know I was having a weird dream, and then it was only there.
See, and you've talked in your dreams before. You've talked in your sleep, and you've yelled at things in your sleep before.
I do yell at things.
And I remember telling you when we were in the apartment about the face that was hovering over you that you were yelling at, because you actually were able to describe it a little bit the next day. But I ran into the bedroom to check on you because you were screaming so loud. And you're like, oh my God, your eyes opened up for a second and your accent came out, which is how I knew you were really upset. And then you were right back into snoozing. So I don't know. I can tell you I've never had an experience with anything like that. Everything I've seen has always been a woman. And we do know the board did say, if you're here, you know, are you male? And it said she. So we know whatever it is we're interacting with, assuming we're interacting with anything at all, is a she. So that we know. Now, chat, Sammy Asa keeps pointing out that the numbers were 57. Those are the two numbers that kept coming up. I remember the 7, but I remember it was kind of sliding this way. But I do know 5 it's gone to 2 or 3 times now.
Yeah.
Umamore's asking, we could ask what its favorite color is. I'm sorry, go ahead. You were going to...
No, I was going to say, with the 57, it's like it definitely stopped on the 5, and then it was sliding, and then you started calling out numbers, because you were going 7, 8, 9, and that's when it went up to no. Because I yelled at you, I was like, you know, you gotta wait until it stops. I mean, it's in transit. There's a definite progression here.
All right, so then that's the place to start. What number comes? What number were you trying to get to after 5? I think is the question we
because
should ask.
It did after it went to no, it did go back down to 6, and then it went to yes, and then there 3 came up at some point, but then there was a no again.
No, Ed, that was in our old apartment. He was asking the question of when you thought I came home that one time, and I hadn't come home, but you saw me going to the back. That was in our old apartment. That was before we moved here.
That was still the one of the most frightening things, yeah. I think.
Whoa, shit. The hell? All right, it's going all the way up to yellow, and it's staying.
I think that means that we should probably start asking questions.
All right. What number were you trying to go to after 5? Still lighting up.
What's it on?
It's not really on anything. Partially on the 0. And we're back to no.
All right.
So is the answer 50?
Trying not to go off the board, because I know that's really freaking difficult, and I understand your otherworldly frustration with that. So...
Were you trying to say 50? 50. So 50.
That is weird.
Are you the same person who was here with us when we started this? K2's gone quiet. Oh, shit. K2's flashing yellow. R. E.
You're going off the fucking board again.
I'm
what
not...
the what the hell?
Fuck? What the fuck is this thing doing? The hell was that? R-E off the board. And what was the question I asked? The question I asked is, are you the same person as who's here before? R-E, then off the board.
Chat's going crazy.
If it spells red rum, nope, I'm the fuck out. All right, well, that was interesting. All right, so as odd as that was, when we first started, the K2 EMF meter, yellow is about right here in the center. I'm hoping you guys can actually see this. I can't. The screen that I can see is way across the room, and I can't see if the flash is actually showing up yet. But these three were flashing for probably a good half minute. When we got to the yes, and then we started coming down here to the R, it stopped. So everything after that, there was nothing going on. Then we went back up to here. Oh, no, we went back up to here. And
it
flashed.
It kept going.
And then it flashed again, and then it stopped right as we were off the board. But,
man,
the Ovilus is still not going off. If this goes off, this should go off in theory. They're measuring the same way. So right now, to me, it doesn't make any sense that this is going off. But this is not going off. That puzzles me. And I know this is on because I can see the light flashing that shows that it's on. Brand new batteries. I just put them in before we came on the air.
We've had the Ovilus go off, though, without the K2 going off.
True. True.
So,
that is true.
I don't know that...
All right. Manly Stuff is saying Reno. Ace is saying Re. It wants to go to Reno. You can see it pretty well? Okay, cool.
That's good.
Cool. So you guys saw the flashing. All right. And just to be clear, there's like nothing under the table, is there, that could set that off? I don't think so. Not unless you're holding a device down there.
Oh, Hex. You foreshadowing bastard, you. I'm so glad that you mentioned that.
Oh, God. Here we go. I was afraid this. You actually did this.
I tried to shut this down. I had a planchet that was shaped like a fish, and I was so excited.
No, Vampy, you ain't seen nothing yet.
It does. And it has the Norwegian letters. I made that for some... I don't remember.
Yeah, it was years... All right, folks. Here,
it was a while ago.
Here is Baroness's Norwegian board.
You know what? I'm tired of this, like... This is ridiculous.
I'm not done with that yet.
I'm setting it over here because obviously,
right, you set it over there. Obviously
we need some help here.
Now we have to do Baroness's Norwegian board that she made over a year ago.
I have no idea where the fish planchet went. It was pretty fucking cool. It was orange and it actually looked kind of like Nemo from that movie. And
I just went on record, folks. I tried to shut this down.
This part was the eye. It was fantastic. Anyway, I forget. I don't even remember why we did this.
We? There's no we in this. This is all
there's
you.
There's a reason this came up. All right.
Bippy Industries was probably when we were doing the skits. So this would have been like 2 years ago. Because we haven't done a radio skit for Bippy Industries in a long time.
Bippy Industries comes up an awful lot in RCM.
They forgot. Oh, we forgot to say goodbye. Portal of Hell confirmed. That's because we're not done yet.
Yeah. Yeah. We're definitely like, we're just letting our spirit friend like go get a drink or, you know, I don't know, apologize to the cat maybe? I'm a little upset about that, I'm not going to lie. All right. You're not going to do this, are you? You are being very close-minded right now, Baron. You are being very close-minded.
I just want to know that I'm doing this in protest. No, I said
it's
protest.
Fine. It's fine. We'll just go back to your very close-minded, only one alphabet board. I'm ready.
You do not seem like you're in the positive mindset to be ready.
They put fish
I said we could do the damn Norwegian board. Let's do the Norwegian board. Otherwise, I'm gonna like I'm gonna hear about this like for the next week. Let's just do this. I'm assuming that's the center of the board.
Probably.
Are you Norwegian? Well, it's not the only thing that's confused in this room.
If it doesn't speak Norwegian, it might not know which way to put the thing.
All right, tell you what. If you want us to make this Norwegian board go away, say something on the obelisk. Anything. I don't care what it is.
Also, ja is yes.
Please say something on the obelisk. I'm not being close-minded at all. Baron, you don't look like you have a very open mind. It's because right now I don't. F. U.
You're moving this, aren't you?
Nope, I haven't touched it. I, fee-fi-fo-fum.
Not done yet. So.
H. Well, it's mostly in the H. It's like almost right between the G and the H.
Oh, we're going off the board again. Damn it, Bippy Industries!
Is this goodbye?
Actually, it is. Actually, it literally was! There.
No Norwegian spirits today, folks.
I can't believe that. Oh, all right. Wait. What's on the other side? Oh, nothing.
It feels a lot lighter than it should be. I want to find, like, an actual Ouija board.
At least it's made in the USA. Huzzah.
Good to know. Portals of Hell are made in the USA. God is American, and we've just confirmed it. Sounds like something out of the 1980s. All right, so for those of you here who are still with us, you poor saps. Looks like I'm not the only one who's a sap here. You guys let me know. Do you guys want to do a few more things with the Ouija board, or do you guys want to move on to our next topic? Because it is almost 6:30. It's actually going pretty well, I think. It's a very informal buy. Funny, I had a young woman describe herself as that earlier.
What?
She's an informal buy. Oh, there's the dawn of comprehension right there.
Like, what are you talking about?
But
gotta love the English language. All right, let's do this.
All right, Edgar says he's good to move on. I still think it's interesting, though. All joking aside, that this was actually going off while we were doing it. With nothing, right. There's like no magnetic field anywhere. That puzzles me. So how do the runes work? You brought the runes out.
I have no idea how the runes work. Oh, and that's not entirely true. So it's supposed to be, it's an actual alphabet, and it was used for language, basically. But they started using them for divination purposes. So there's, like, different meanings attached to each thing, and you're supposed to have all of your runes, once they're charged, which mine are not charged, because, again, it was more for, like, educational purposes than, you know, actual things. But once they have, like, the proper, like, energies and stuff, you're supposed to have them in a bag, and, you know, you're supposed to reach in and feel around until you find the one that you feel like you're supposed to have. And then you pull it out. This one, I don't know. And then it tells you, like, you look it up or you know what it is and it tells you, you know, things to guide you, basically. So.
This all seems very subjective, doesn't it?
All of this is very subjective. Which is what makes it interesting, because...
Which is why I've introduced science. Well, pseudoscience. We don't really know if it's actually... We know it's measuring something, we're just not entirely certain what.
Alright, we need some questions, though.
Well...
Because you're going to get, like, super excited about WrestleMania in, like, 23 minutes, so...
I'm about super excited. Definitely looking forward to it.
I'm still...
two matches in particular.
I'm still entertained by the fact that I was looking up... I was lazy Googling pretentious names for villains last night as a placeholder thing, and the first five things that came up was from some e-wrestling thing where the guy's name was literally pretentious villain. That still makes me happy. Well, I was entertained.
At least you know
that.
Exactly where he falls on the scale. All right, so we're gonna go call it quits now with the Ouija board. So goodbye. Here, touch it. There, goodbye.
Goodbye, spirit. Please we'll stop scaring my cat.
We will come back to this in future episodes because I'm not done with it. And I think if we did something a little bit seriously, maybe even brought in a third person, I think we'd be kind of curious to see what kind of results we get. We're going to let the ghost hunting equipment continue running just in case, because now we're going to do see if stuff goes off even without the Ouija board presence. You know, a little bit of comparison here, since that is the variable we want to measure. But what we are going to do, and since I do have a second camera angle, I can actually show you guys shit now. Let's go to the murder mystery thing real quick here. Because I'm told you guys can actually see this pretty well.
As you block everything with your box.
Well, the one will talk. The other one I'm not... The obvious I'm not so worried about making its presence known. It's the K2 we want to make sure we cover here. Alright, so this is what you get with the package from the Hunt a Killer. And the Hunt a Killer is what we talked about last week. We started going through the evidence, trying to figure out how we're going to go ahead and solve this. So this is the packaging that you get. This is the weird little manual. It's an empty manual. I'm assuming you can use this to write your notes and do your research and stuff on. It's actually pretty good quality, I think, for an item that they send here.
We did use the black light, so there's no secret messages inside.
That is true. Here is the random ketchup packet thing. So, again, we're not sure what the usefulness is of this, but they did say that pretty much it's a subscription. So when you sign up for this, every month, as long as you're willing to pay for it, you will get another package that will expand on your current story, as well as eventually start branching out into additional side stories or side quests, if you will. So there's additional mysteries you can solve as you go along here. Right now, what we're trying to figure out is what exactly is the mystery that we're supposed to solve. So the first two things that they send us that when we open this up is this little chart here. Hopefully you guys can see this. And this picture of the swan. Now, in this picture right here, this is, how do they describe it? The horizon of London, England, northern sky at 10 p.m. September 23rd, at 9 p.m. October 8th, and 8 p.m. October 23rd. And then here you go. It shows the sky and different scars, you know, charts and shit like that. Then there's the picture of the swan. No idea what purpose this serves yet, but it's just a green picture, and there's a little swan here, and he's swimming around doing his thing. Then here's the letter that's... is part of the agency that we signed up for, the Listening Friends of America. Now, what this assumes is that we've now signed up for a group called Listening Friends of America, which is a corporation that's made just for the sake of the game. But they have a website. There's clues hidden on the website you can go look for. It's actually pretty interesting how they have this set up. But basically what this group is all about is we signed up to have letters and exchanges with prisoners, inmates, people in nursing homes and hospice care, people that are cut off from society, they have no friends, they have no family, or they're incarcerated and they can't have connections. And basically what it is they put or write down whatever it is that they want in a letter, and they send it to you, and you can read it at your own leisure. And the theory behind it is if you express what it is that's bothering you or express your innermost thoughts and desires, and you just share them with other people, that it can be very therapeutic and very helpful. You send it off into the great ether knowing someone's going to read it, and then supposedly this helps you therapeutically. So that's basically what the Listening Friends of America are all about. So the letter is pretty much introducing you. Hey, welcome to the friends. Here's your person. By the way, if you feel at any point that you're threatened or there's anything that's really, really scary, let us know and we will reassign you to somebody else. By the way, thank you for doing this. Also included was this news article that actually is a real article from the Baltimore Sun. You okay?
I know who HG is.
Who's HG? Going back to our Ouija board here, You look like you're stunned by this. Who's HG?
The the prior owner of our house.
Right.
Went by Glenn. But because we keep getting his mail, we know that his name was actually Howard Glenn. And then his last name.
But then why would it say it's she?
I don't know. That doesn't make sense, but that is an odd coincidence.
Hmm. That is kind of interesting.
Okay.
Well, now I kind of want to break out the Ouija board again.
Continue. Right.
But anyway, we'll do more Ouija board stuff here in the future, future episodes. But anyway, this is a news article that actually came from the Baltimore Sun, and of course, there's things that are redacted here. So what we did while we were on the air is we pulled up the news article and we replaced all the words that were redacted out of it. And of course, some things repeated. There were some words that stood out over others. There are some words that were redacted in some places, but not in other places. Just weird little things here. So you guys can hopefully see some of that here. Then you get a letter from the friend. This is the letter from the inmate or the individual that we are currently paired up with through the Listening Friends of America. And then their letter is right here on a specialty paper. It's much thicker than everything else that's in here. And as you go through it, and I started underlining passages and words, a lot of the things that he mentions in here are also mentioned on the news article we looked up. So he's telling us in his letter what to look for here. So we're assuming he's the one that sent us this entire package. So he's trying to communicate something to us, and that's what we're trying to figure out at this point. And in his letter, he also mentions that he's a fan of puzzles, and that he might have done something that he wants to tell us about, but we have to do some digging. He's just not going to come right out and say what it is. So right now, we don't know who we're interacting with. My theory is it's somebody in prison, just based on how he describes things here in the letter. But he's kind of pointing us in the direction of looking at the news article and, of course, looking up on the website. So far, we've also gone digging on the Listening Friends website, and we also found a puzzle that was on there, which Hacks actually in chat solved. I forget where I wrote down his answers to it.
I can pull him up if you need him.
No, that's all right.
We were double-checking some things the next day, so...
This was an additional envelope that came in here. I'm trying to cover up my actual mailing address. Too late now.
It's a little bit late for that now.
Now, supposedly, Listening Friends of America actually inspects this and takes on anything that's questionable. Of course, the question is, did they add anything as well, which obviously we don't know. So, this is just an envelope that goes with it. And then this is an additional letter just describing, welcome to the killing community. Here's how to actually play the game. And what they say is pretty much, you know, discover, you can go dig in as far as you want. Where do you start? It's anyone's guess. And anyone who plays this game all gets this first package. So if you decide to sign up for this, this will be actually the same exact package you're going to get. My goal is, if we team up with our listenership, we might be able to solve this mystery like we did the last one that we did from the Mysterious Package Company. So that is pretty much what we have so far in the killer thing. Just to go ahead and refresh everybody's memory, I will get specific photos of a lot of this stuff up and posted on our Discord thread so you guys can participate and we can start digging into this thing. We're not going to get the next package until the 22nd of April because they get mailed out the 22nd. So it'll be whatever the couple days after that we're going to get this. Because I did go ahead and re-up for the next one. It's $30 a month to do this, guys, so I don't know how long we're going to be able to do this.
As long as I'm entertained by it, obviously.
Yeah, but it's a lot of money to go throwing out into a potential game. So that's where we're at right now. So that is what we have so far. Like I said, I will get more information for you guys and more pictures up for you guys pretty soon. So you guys know exactly where it is that we left off. Now we're mixing our Ouija board and mystery puzzle. Edgar is showing like a shocked face. So nothing on here so far, obviously. So let's move on to a couple of our other stories here. I'm going to pull my computer up now just because it's easier to read than having to turn around all the time. A couple of the things that came up this week.
If you're going to type, you might want to move the microphone because it's going to pick up from the table.
Should be all right.
No, I had to mute it earlier because I could hear you doing it.
Oh, gotcha. Well, I won't type too much. Okay. Most of it's already pulled up here.
Yay!
So for those who's joining us, we just finished our experiment with the Ouija board. It'll be the first of many experiments to come. Trying to see if our ghost hunting equipment will work off with the Ouija board. We had some instances where it seemed like it did. Most of the time it didn't seem like it was. We have a few couple things to look at. A possible name now with Howard Glenn or Glenn Howard or whatever the fuck it is. We can look that up too. Although still wondering why it's said female when it's not, but
There might have been multiple people there. Who knows?
That is true.
I mean, we weren't getting very strong signals, so...
That is true. All right, so let's start with this one, because this one I think is kind of bullshit, and this one's potentially rant-happy. So it's not exactly a huge surprise to say out there in the great ether of media that a lot of ideas for movies come from books, they come from TV shows, they also come from video games. I mean, we've had video game movies based on video games before. The Super Mario Brothers, the less said about that, the better. Silent Hill, which is probably the only good one they ever made. Tomb Raider, so on and so forth. So there's another game that just came out. It's a newer game. It hasn't been out that long. And this has already impressed somebody in Hollywood so much that it's been optioned for a movie. But here's the kicker, though. The game hasn't even been fully released yet. It's currently in early access. It's only been out for like 2 months. And it's not even completed. So not only do we not know what the full story is, we only have a synopsis, but Vampy, who's played the beta to this, has told me it's not really not worth playing at this point because there's nothing really to it. It's a difficult game to play because the controls and shit suck. So basically, they made this video game. Well, they haven't finished making it yet. They haven't even released the full thing yet, but it's so impressive they made a movie. And we're talking about the video game We Happy Few. Now, the premise of We Happy Few is that it takes place in a weird version of the future where everybody takes some kind of happy pill to delude themselves into realizing how horrible reality is. Okay? That's the whole point. And your character stops taking the happy pills, and they come and people start looking, oh, you're a downer, you're off your pills, and then they try to kill you. So basically, it's a game where you're trying to blend in with the populace and not get murdered, because you don't want to take happy pills anymore and hide from the realities of life. So this comes from DreadCentral.com, which is one of the more reliable horror-type sites. Compulsion Games' We Happy Few is the latest video game that is being adapted into a feature-length film, according to Variety. The video game developer will be working with Gold Circle Entertainment as well as DJ2 Entertainment, per the website. Video game developer Compulsion Games has partnered with DJ2 Entertainment for the project. Paul Brooks, the CEO and CEO of DJ2, Dimitri Johnson, and Chief Content Officer, blah, 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 will produce the project with DJ2's Steven Bruger, blah, 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 whatever, I don't care. The game is currently in early access, and Compulsion Games promises the finished version of We Happy Few will be out for everyone to enjoy before the release of the film. Okay. So here's the part I don't get. We Happy Few has a very exciting premise of a game. It looks like it'd be very entertaining when it's completed. Right now, they're basically developing a video game franchise into a movie franchise with something they don't even know if it's going to be successful yet. They don't even know what the full extent of the game is yet. But they're going to turn this into a movie? What the fuck sense does that make?
They turned Battleship into a movie.
But Battleship has been a successful board game for how many years? Very successful.
It's a board game. It's not a story. I mean, well, you can't just, which you is can't why it involved aliens. Random images and, you know, boobs on a freaking screen and call it, you know, cinema. That's retarded.
Actually, they can and they did. Many times.
No.
But if you look at Super Mario Brothers, that was an extremely successful franchise at the time it got its movie. Silent Hill, extremely successful franchise. Tomb Raider, Resident Evil, the list goes on. All these video games were based on existing properties that had multiple games that established an entire franchise. Now you're talking about taking a game that's not even a franchise, hasn't even been completed yet, and you're optioning it into a movie. Now that's not saying that this thing can't be successful and it can't be good. I mean, it very well could be. I mean, the potential is there. But why? You don't even know if you have anything good yet. You don't even know if the story's good yet. And they're going to option this into a movie. Okay, I'm all for Hollywood doing something original instead of doing remakes. And speaking of which, we're going to talk about a remake here in a few minutes. I'm all for doing something new and different. But this? I don't know. It's very baffling to me as to why that would be the case.
Vampy thinks it's a good premise.
It can be, but it just doesn't make sense as to why they would do it on something that hasn't even been completed. Okay, the movie Hannibal, it was Hannibal Rising, which is the fourth movie in the Hannibal series. Actually, Hannibal 2. Hannibal was based on the third book of Thomas Harris's series based on Hannibal Lecter. The third book wasn't even done yet when the movie was being worked on. The fourth one, if I remember right, the movie came out before the book was done. doesn't make any sense. It's like, we're going to write this for the sole purpose of making it into a movie. Okay, fine. You know, they do novelizations of movies all the time. Mm-hmm. But they're still established franchises. Mm-hmm. It's just baffling to me. I just don't get it. All right, so chat. Some people in chat don't seem like this is necessarily a bad idea. I am very torn to it. I'm not against it. If it turns out to be a successful movie and video game, more power to them. I'm just surprised that movie groups and movie companies that are so adverse to taking a risk anymore are willing to risk something that hasn't been proven yet. That to me is surprising. So somebody is a very big fan of the premise to this. And my guess is somebody at the gaming studio has already had their eyes set on the big screen before they even started working on this thing. Because for a deal like that to get done this quickly, I just don't buy that to be happen chance. I'm willing to bet somebody really loved the idea and said, hey, let's shop this in another media while we're working on this version. Which to me is silly because you just don't even have a working game yet. You need to focus on the game. Worry about everything else afterward. I mean, we've seen companies get into that situation time and time again. They're so busy working on marketing and coming out with content that they're not focusing on actually making the game working. You know, Mass Effect Andromeda is going through something similar. Dead by Daylight's going through something similar. It's getting more and more prevalent. So, I don't know. To me, it's just baffling. So, the other thing that I want to talk about, and this will be the last topic we'll do for today because we do have to finish a little bit early, or actually probably finish on time. More is more like it. So, many of you guys may know, a certain movie dropped its trailer earlier this week.
Baron's super excited about this.
I'm totally hyped. Yes, I'm hyped as shit. So, we've all said this before. If it doesn't involve a prison, nobody has ever successfully made a good Stephen King movie based on Stephen King material. Never pulled it off, ever. And what I saw from this movie trailer for the movie It, which is a remake of the 1990s version and a more truthful adaptation of the book, allegedly, I am very, very impressed with how this thing looks. It looks scary. It looks creepy. The kid actors look good. It really honestly feels like they took a page out of Stranger Things when they were developing this movie with the kids, which is hilarious because my first thought watching Stranger Things is like, wow, it's like watching a Stephen King novel, which is to me a huge compliment.
You said too.
I know I've said it because that's what it made me think of. And I'm not the only one. I've had multiple conversations with people about Stranger Things. Wow, this feels like if you're actually watching a Stephen King story done well. It looks like a Stephen King movie done well. Now, again, this is just the first trailer. Obviously, there's a lot that remains to be seen. But as far as trailers go, this is one of the most successful ones ever. And I'm not just talking about my personal feelings on it. If you look up the different web articles about, in fact, here, bloodydisgusting.com, the It trailer totally just shattered all global traffic records for the internet. All right, so hold on. Let me skip down here. Not surprisingly, the trailer is slaying all across the internet, shattering records along the way. We've just learned that Its trailer has broken an all online global traffic records with 197 million views in the first 24 hours. The previous record holder was The Fate and the Furious, had 139 million views in 24 hours.
Which also amazes me. I mean, The Fate of the Furious is like, what, number 127 in that series?
Yeah, you want to talk about a franchise that won't die. It's still got its huge fans. So basically, you went from one of the most successful openings for The Fate and the Furious at 139, and then topped it with 197.
Never fails!
Yeah, I know. Cell phone. Where's my button? Here. There we go.
Did you just answer it on air?
No.
Hold on.
It went to missed call. My aunt just ruined my rage here.
Hang on. You're
139 to 197. So it did just beat it. It beat the fucking shit out of it. All right. That is cool to see. To date, the It trailer has now reached 246 million views. And that's as of the time this article came out. Which came out March 31st, so a few days ago.
Yeah, a couple days ago.
And the trailer only dropped earlier this week. Now compare that to the Ghostbusters reboot and how it was the most hated movie ever, or the most hated movie trailer ever. And we've got some funny things going here. All right, so basically, and it just keeps going on talking about all the different things that broke. And this thing doesn't come out till September 8th. So they're releasing trailers fairly early, which is cool. That means the company that made this movie is very confident it's going to be good. The director who made it is the guy also filmed the movie Mama, which I thought was a very underrated horror film. It's not great by any stretch of the imagination, but it does what a good horror movie should do. Good atmosphere, good characters, good scares. And the fact that they're putting this movie in this guy's capable hands, to me, is pretty surprising that they're going to do it for a nobody, because he is still a nobody, even though he had a successful movie, but that they're giving him the budget to do it. Now, my guess is, and what I've heard, is they're going to split it into two parts. For those of you unfamiliar with the story of It, first off, shame on you. You need to read it. It's an excellent book, especially better than anything Stephen King's done in the last 10 years. But anyway, It is a story about these six kids in Derry, Maine. It takes place in the 1960s, and then it also takes place in the present day 1985, as all these kids as adults. So basically the book opens up that one of the characters that survived as kids calls all the individual characters back as adults to come back to Derry, Maine, because it has resurfaced again. And it came back earlier than it usually does. It usually comes back in like 25-year intervals and slaughters a whole bunch of kids, then disappears for a while. Nobody knows why. Of course, you find out through the course of the movie why. So as they return to Derry one by one, their memories start coming back because they have no memory of what happened as their kids until they get that phone call, which they all thought was very interesting. So as they all return to Derry, their memories start playing back, and then the story goes back in time to when they were kids, unveiling what happened with it and what happened as them as kids. And it's very interesting, the different dynamics and how everything goes between that. But and then it's about them now as adults trying to figure out how they're going to stop this thing now they no longer have the power that what they had when they were kids. Which is, and it's convoluted, but it makes a lot more sense if you read the book. But basically, that's what it is. Six people get called back to their hometown to kill this thing, and their memories start coming back of what happened when they were kids, when they first met this thing. And it's just such a well-done story. It's just by far one of the best novels he ever did. And I'm excited because, as another article points out, it feels like the remake that actually needs to exist. We talk all the time about movies and TV shows and video games. Oh, wow, it's a reboot. It's a remake. Spider-Man's getting rebooted for the third time in 15 years. Really? Really? That's just dumb. It, however, was first done in 1990, and the 1990s version was a made-for-TV miniseries. And it starred, you know, John Ritter. I like John Ritter. I think he's a good actor, but he's not a horror actor. Although Tim Curry as Pennywise was definitely an excellent, excellent part. Take him out of the equation, and the whole thing's is just abysmally awful instead of just awful. And Stephen King's stories, again, as we touched on at the start of this, outside of a prison story like Shawshank, Green Mile, has never had a good adaptation ever. Not once, not once that I can think of. Pet Sematary had its moments, but overall, bad movie. This seems like for the first time that a Hollywood studio, Hollywood company is getting it right. And that they're putting the time and effort into getting this right. Not just because of the quality of the trailer, but the quality of the individual they have involved, and just the sheer confidence they have to release this so early. You have other movies that are coming out sooner than this that still haven't dropped the trailer yet, which tells me that that company's worried it's not going to be very good. These guys are like, nope, we're putting it out there. And they're doing a nice job of kind of like hinting at what Pennywise might look at. Of course, people with technology now, they're able to take still frames out of videos and post it. So we know what Pennywise is going to look like. He looks fucking terrifying. And it just looks like it's going to be something special. And that's what I'm hoping it is. I'm hoping that the early hype that's coming to this movie actually lives up to be as good as it looks. No, Baron, we've discussed this. You can't talk about the hype. The hype's going to be poor. Old It movie is the reason I don't like clowns. I think it's a good reason why a lot of people don't like clowns. I'm not sure about the ending. That is pretty sketchy. Not sure how far they will go keeping with the book. Salem's Lot wasn't half bad. I think they're going to split it into two movies, though, rather than just do one. The first movie is probably going to be about them as kids. The second movie is going to be them as adults, their adult versions, incarnations, getting called back in the dairy. Now, what I'm nervous about that one is when they're adults, there's really not much of the story. The bulk of the story is when they're kids. And then the last portion is when they're adults going down to the sewers to go fight it one last time. After they recall the memories and then trying to deal with the fact that now they're not a complete six anymore because some members have died. And how they're going to try to overcome this and when they can't complete the rituals that beat them the first time. So I think that's what they're going to do. That's my guess. But again, this is early on. We haven't seen any clips of them as adults yet, but that could change. So we'll have to wait and see. But I do like the idea that they're going to do this right. They're not going to half-ass it. This isn't going to be, let's take a 1,000-page novel and let's cram it into an hour and a half. We're not going to have that this time. They're going to take their time. They're going to do it right. If they split it into two movies, all the better. They need to do what they did with Green Mile. Green Mile was an excellent movie that was up for all sorts of Academy Awards, including Best Picture, Best Actor, and Best Director. And it was like a 4.5-hour movie. And the book wasn't even anywhere near as long as it was. But it just showed, when you take the time to do justice to the original creation, you get something special. Green Mile is a very special movie. Shawshank Redemption was a very special movie. That was based on a short story, for God's sakes. You're taking one of his most beloved classics, and you're going to do it, and you're going to do it well. And I'm hoping that's the case. It looks really freaking good. And if you have not seen this trailer, ladies and gentlemen, I do encourage you, watch it, see what you think. And then definitely give us some feedback. I want to hear what you guys think about the new It movie. I'm very hyped and very excited for it. I think it's going to do it well. And I cannot wait for the next trailer, which is probably like another 2 months away before we get trailer number two. But I cannot freaking wait to see it. And I don't think you've watched it yet.
The otherwise, trailer?
Yeah.
No.
Oh my God, it looks so good. So there you go. So It is already breaking traffic records on the internet. It's already got the hype machine going behind it. It is very, very exciting. All right, the last thing
the thing that I find very exciting.
Yes, here, I'll let you drive for this one, because I've done the majority of the talking here. But this one's pretty cool. I think this is ghost gossip. So I think this
ghost gossip.
This goes for your ghost gossip.
We
stuff.
Will eventually record a ghost gossip drop in. Although we wouldn't be able to use it right now anyway. So, anyway, Bela Lugosi allegedly haunting his old home, and now it's for sale. This comes from Bloody Disgusting.
It won't suck your blood and haunt your house.
You can hang out with Bela Lugosi for just $3 million.
$3 million? Are you crazy? That's insanely cheap. What a deal.
Do you believe in ghosts? If you do, then perhaps you buy into the stories that the late horror legend Bela Lugosi haunts the Los Angeles home he once lived in. Famous psychic Sylvia Brown.
Really?
Let me pause for a minute.
I fucking hate that bitch. Yeah, after what she did to some of those families, no. Oh my God. Can't stand her.
Anyway, famous psychic once visited the home, which rests under the iconic Hollywood sign, and reported seeing the spirit of long-dead Lugosi roaming the halls in his Dracula cape. Now there's a mental image for ya.
You know how fucking creepy that'd be? Not just Bela Lugosi's ghost, but him dressed as Dracula nonetheless. Holy shit! That'd be creepy. Awesome, but creepy!
Lugosi lived in the Beechwood Canyon home between 1934 and 1937, which means he purchased it shortly after the release of Universal's Dracula. As reported by Realtor.com, the remodeled mansion, which was built in 1930 and is referred to as Westshore Manor, Castle La Paloma, or the Bela Lugosi home,
that seems more straightforward,
went up for sale this week with an asking price of $3 million. It was built by architect Frank W. Green, started in 1930, finished in 1932. It has a magnificent construction and classic details not often found. Now, this is from its actual listing. Ballroom-sized living room with massive stone fireplace, formal dining with banks of iron glass windows, a library and a fourth bedroom with its own entrance, and a bright chef's kitchen with I don't even know what the hell that word is, and service entrance. So we've got, like, tons of bedrooms, mahogany and peg groove floors, lots of handmade ironwork. I mean, that just smacks of vampirism right there. If you are a true goth, you are going to put up that $3 million right now. And if you don't have the $3 million to put up for this home, talk to Bubba, because he can tell you about something called loans.
I think true goths don't know who Bela Lugosi is.
That makes me so sad inside. Ooh! Other celebrities who have lived in the 3,484-square-foot Tudor include Kathy Bates and John Cryer. It's located on Westshore Drive in Los Angeles, California. And they've got some pictures up here.
We'll, I know they used to live in Bela Lugosi's house. How long has he been dead now? It's
long,
yeah, a long time.
Time.
The original Dracula.
Yeah, to be perfectly honest, as I'm looking at these pictures, I mean that kitchen's... All the rooms are very oddly shaped.
Well, it's California. They always build things weird out there.
Although, creepily, that bedroom looks very similar to what I had in mind for fictional killer's bedroom in his house in the fanfic stories.
There you go. So you got some inspiration. So for those of you that want to buy a $3 million house in California and live out with all those crazies, there you go. Oh, all right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, with that being it, we're pretty much right at the 0 hour here at 7 o'clock.
And Edgar's saying, I just hope you can afford your own cleaning crew to keep it in livable and good shape. If you got $3 million to drop on a house, man.
That is true.
I'm pretty sure that...
I just build my own. Oh, all right. Well, like I said, that's pretty much going to do it for us, guys. Thank you for watching. The items have been pretty quiet here, other than when the laptop got close. But that's because the laptop's just picking up signal off there. That's going to do it for us. I don't know. Next week, do we want to do a Ghost in the Podcast, or is it a gaming week?
Next week, I will be in Pennsylvania.
That is right. So next week's going to be a Let's Play
which
week.
Which is why we had Ghost in the Podcast this week instead.
So there you go, guys. Next week is going to be a Let's Play. I'll probably start around 3 o'clock in the afternoon. I know we're like talking a week out. Well, I'll remind you guys throughout the week.
Unless
through
Bela Lugosi
streams.
Gets him. His ghost gets him.
I really don't think Bela Lugosi is haunting here. Why would he come here? He's got a $3 million paradise to walk around in and haunt.
Because freaking psychics kept showing up to his house. I mean, maybe he got fed up.
Yeah, she ain't a psychic. But anyway.
Let's pull out the Ouija board and find out if Bela Lugosi showed up.
I'd rather pull out the Ouija board and find out officially that Sylvia Brown's not worth shit. But I think we already know that. All right, so thank you guys for watching tonight. We did do the Ouija board stuff. We will be going in and posting this video and the audio up for you guys to download pretty soon. We will continue doing the Hunt a Killer stuff. Don't forget, you can go on our Discord channel. It's very easy to find out. Just put in !! Discord in chat, and you will find out how to go ahead and get access to it. And then go ahead, and if you have ideas, if you have suggestions, things that you found out about the Hunt a Killer stuff you want us to know, things for us to think about, any theories as to what we could do, and please take this legitimately seriously here. Go ahead and throw them up in Discord. We want to hear from you. If you got suggestions and feedback and how you want, what you think of our show, all the other shows that are here on the Rivalcast Media Network, as long as our Let's Plays, games you want us to look at, news tidbits, anything, we want to hear from you. We want to know. I said this last week, I'll say it again. The biggest comment we're getting is more YouTube content. We are working on it, folks. We're working on it diligently. Hopefully we'll have some things for you guys, to talk about sometime soon. You're going to be having Varyar coming up later tonight. He's going to be coming up probably about a half hour or so to play some XCOM. We are still filling in for D. He's out for at least one more week on his vacation. And then I will be going in and continuing to take up his Wednesday slot. Varyar will also be taking his Monday slot. So you will still have all sorts of Rivalcast Media content for your consummation, whatever, right here on twitch.tv/Rivalcast Media. Anything else that I'm forgetting to announce?
Probably, but I can't think of it right now.
All right. Well, we could ask the Ouija board, but I don't think I want to do that. So on behalf of myself and Baroness, thank you for watching. We'll see you guys next week, or in 2 weeks. And remember, if anybody asks you if you're a god, say yes. Oh, we should ask the Ouija board that. If someone asks you if you're a god, what do you say? And then see what the Ouija board says.
Oh, my God. That would be cool.
We'll do that. We'll do that 2 weeks. We'll have to remember that.
All right. Yeah.
So you're welcome, Ace. Glad you guys had fun tonight. We'll see you later.